Hello everyone, Malekith here, and welcome to Tabletop Racing World Tour. Now this is going to be one of my first look style videos, the slight difference being I have actually played this before. Usually when I do first look videos, it's the first time I've booted the game up, and that's what you get to see, but I kind of knew in advance this one would be, I won't say grindy, but it follows that sort of Gran Turismo style thing where you buy the reasonably priced terrible car, have to do some Sunday league races to earn the terrible trophies to then unlock the next one and eventually progress to something that looks remotely like a racing car. So we can see my original ones was... Nope, wrong way. This was the original vehicle I had. It's obviously a highly professional racing machine. It's even called the Tijuana Taxi. It didn't handle very well. Races were not speed demon sort of things going on. But you unlock the next category and then you get to race something slightly larger. Now, as well as unlocking the vehicles, you do get some upgrades. You can see here we can pay coins, which you get through winning races. You can also pick them up as you drive around in the races. To upgrade the stats of the vehicle, you can change the paint job if you wanted. Alternatively, you can start doing some more interesting things, like putting different tyres on. So if you look in the bottom right, you can see the advantage and disadvantage of these tyres. So this one's a drifter tyre, makes it extra slippery, but you won't be setting any lap records. This one, more coins. They get slightly better. Shields to block weapons. You'll see weapons once we get going. The standard traditional James Bond, I'm going to burst your tyre spikes. What else did we have? Jumping. And the peace hippie wheels that stop other people being aggressive. So there's quite a bit of flexibility. When I originally sort of picked up this game, it looked very much like Micro Machines V3. If you know what that game is, welcome to being old. Potentially, if you know what Micro Machines is, welcome to being old. Quick shout out to Moosey in chat. That will be in a little bit, Moosey. If you hop on my TeamSpeak, you're welcome to join in. I'll probably be about 30 minutes with this game. Right, so what do you get up to in this? If we go into the championships, what you'll see is, actually going to one I've already done and I can show you the different race types. So you'll see these symbols all mean a different type of race. So this one is the most sort of basic, it's called combat. It's literally get three laps in, you can fire various pickups. You see the pickups allowed there are bombs, boosts, and rockets. There are a few that aren't unlocked for that mission type, but that's because it's, you know, it's early, it probably unlocks later. You get hot lap, which is just do the fastest lap you can. There's nobody else on the court, on the track. Court? Why did I say court? Time trial. I think you just have to beat a predetermined time. I may have got those two the wrong way around. Neither of them were amazingly interesting to me. This one is no weapons at all, just racing. The one I actually like the most is this one here with the scissors, elimination. Every lap, whoever is last gets knocked out. Don't be last, be first at the end when you're the only one left. So enough of me yapping about what's going on, just trying to show you the variety because I may not actually get to show you it by doing all of the race types. What have we got here? Pursuit. Okay, this one's slightly different. I didn't mention this one. There's an opponent that's trying to get away. You've got to try and catch him. So let's have a go at this. Bear in mind, I haven't played this for a few weeks. I've probably forgotten all of the controls, but never mind. I also haven't worked out when you have to accelerate to get the boost start. So if you get a double boost, you get like an extra high charge. So pick up one pickup, you get a small boost. Pick up a second one of the same type, you get a faster boost out of it. And I've missed a load of pickups there. There are shortcuts on these maps. You'll notice it's going for the Micro Machines feel with the whole sort of you're a small car on a workbench or in a science lab or that kind of stuff, but I don't know, it doesn't quite pull it off as much. The environmental hazards were one of the big things I liked about Micro Machines. So say you're racing along a pool table, there'll just be a queue randomly there, or a ball, or, you know, something that would hamper you. This seems to not really do that too well. Oh, messed that landing up. So yeah, he's getting away. I'm probably needing more practice to actually complete this type of mission. Especially as this is only one of the first races in this new car, which is significantly more powerful than the last one and not handling even remotely the same. On the top right, you'll see the star ratings. They're the times you have to catch him in to qualify for the star bonuses. You need a certain amount of stars to unlock the next race or the next cup, maybe. So we're unlikely to manage it in this one, because I haven't actually gained on him at all, I don't think. And we're getting closer. No, we just fluffed that. And we're going to run out of time. There you go, we got vision on him at least. We were gaining. I just needed to not be quite so terrible. We will actually go try the other race. I've got some people I can bounce off maybe there. Oh no, it's a hot lap race. I've got nobody to bounce off at all. I was hoping to show you the combat. It's very Mario Kart-esque. You get some stuff in the way on the workbench, but you kind of just hit it and it flies off. It doesn't seem to really slow you amazingly. You know, it's not... There's a proper physics engine in here, but you just seem to send it flying. You don't... Ah, crap. Well, this is going to be terrible, isn't it? Yeah, you don't seem to actually bounce off it at all. Right, that first lap would never have been a good lap anyway, because it's from a standing start. Your hot lap's always your second or beyond. I should have come from the other side of that. Left and in. Nope, overcooked the brakes. So I've managed to get second, or, you know, the second tier of stars. See what I mean about the physics? You just sort of send it flying. It's got no weight to it. Come on! Ugh. Ah, 2679. I needed 2650. But it got us some stars and some coins and everything else. Now, unfortunately, I need to get some coins in there, I think. Or some stars, even. It's how to handle that jump. The slower cars, you turn sideways in midair, and it works out nicely for you. In this one, it didn't seem to. But maybe it was because I was double boosting at the time. That's better. That's not. Although we're getting closer. Oh no, that was just because we were through the wall, I think. Distance to target, sadly, is as the crow flies and not following the racetrack, which is what would actually be useful. Oh, I missed it. That's not good. Means I should take this fine. No. Let's not boost for this bit, get a double. And boost for this bit. Yeah. There we go, we got sight on him. Come here, you. Gotcha. And that should unlock the next tier. All right, now we can show you the kind of races I like, but that's a new one. What is that? Drift challenge. Go fast, turn hard, and get seriously sideways. Hmm. Not all cars are natural drifters. Oh, drift wheels are fitted to your car automatically for drift mode. That'd be nice, but we're going to show you that elimination match first. You can see all these power-ups then. You can see it definitely gives you that Micro Machines feel with the forces, the sort of the... It's just a shame there's not enough obstacles on it, really. And see, they get a nice speed boost at the start. It's not worked out when you accelerate to get that. It doesn't seem to be the same as Mario Kart's on the amber light. But it's a similar principle. Alright, the lightning, I have to be near people and it disables them for a minute, kind of EMP style. Like, come on. Yeah. Nah, I was out of range of the second one, but got one of them. Oh, now this one is good. This fires an ice cube thing forwards and turns them into an ice block if it hits them. Like that. Apparently he tried to rocket me and I managed to blow it up with the lightning at the same time, which I didn't realise was even possible. I've got a dumb fire rocket. I forgot you can boost them by picking up doubles. That was a new feature that came in when I swapped to this newer high-powered vehicle racing. You only get single power-ups in the lower tier. Makes me wonder what on earth you get for the highest tier, which is still one above this one. Okay, one more lap to go. Oh, it's elimination, isn't it? That's why there's less cars on the track than I thought. It's just the one guy behind me. Hopefully he doesn't get a homing pickup. Or I might be screwed. Nope, we got him. Win. Can you fire behind you? Certain weapons fire backwards. There's like an oil, I think it's an acid slick. That goes backwards. You can't, it's not like Mario Kart where you can fire the green shell forwards or backwards, from what I can tell. You do get those wheel weapons that I was showing you in the shop earlier. You can see at the moment the opponent wheel weapons, there aren't any, so I imagine that comes in at a higher tier. All right, this is this drift challenge that I've never done before, so we'll see how badly this goes. I'm not known for my drift ability in racing games, ever. What? Good luck with this one. Not a chance in hell. It doesn't help when the track straightens out and there's not much you can do about it. Ow. Hit the thing. Knocks it out. There's no point doing it along this straight here, I don't think. Nope. Oh, I see. There's like a... Is there a one longest drift and then a total score? Maybe I was misreading the left-hand side. I thought you had to get those values in one long drift. That might explain things a bit. Oh yeah, best drift and total score. That actually makes things more workable. But, oh, I lost it. Yep, stop myself crashing there just to get the points. There we go. Nearly at the point where we're going to get one star now. I nudged it. Yeah, mom. Lock that in, that should get us the... Nope, not enough to get the first. I'd definitely be interested to see how this plays in multiplayer, but I don't know how many people actually have it. This, unfortunately, is one of the least interesting race types in my mind. Pure racing is, you know, nothing but racing. No boosts, no weapons. There is gratuitous ramming, of course. And shortcuts. And paint cans. Ooh, nearly messed that one up. Now we've got to catch this last guy, which is not going to be as easy as it sounds. Because I just mess things up like that occasionally. Where's a rocket when you want one? We've got two more laps. I always take that corner badly. It may be that I need to put some upgrades in my car, to be perfectly honest. I am running the stock version of this tier 2 car. My top speed's not great. Oh well, at least we get second. Alright, let's go put some upgrades on this thing. Yeah, top speed. And again, one in handling. How much are the wheels? Block incoming weapons. No. I kind of wanted those, but I've just spent too much money. Right, well, we'll go give that a try. That's a time trial, and this one is combat, which is of course what you guys want to see, and it's got more weapons. It's all the weapons. Oh, that's gripping a lot better. Boom! 2 for 1. This is the acid bath. Pick up. I just need to get in front of them. There we go. No. There we go. Got some of them. Not the ones directly behind me. Alright, extra powerful EMP lightning. Oh, someone just had a rocket shot on me. Yikes! Alright, I've got homing rockets now. I don't know what the double powered up version of them does. But we've got nobody in front of us to target anyway, but it's a good one to have. J-Wall in chat remembers Micro Machines. He's saying it's giving off that vibe. I agree. I just wish things like this had more impact. More things to dodge. The tracks are a little open, bare, however you want to describe it. Too clean. You need like sticky glue on the ground that you can accidentally drive through, and weird Cheerios that you can drive into and get stopped by. All those sorts of weird and wonderful things Micro Machines used to have back in the day. Oh yeah, giant cats that tried to squash you. That was another one. I think there's a giant frog as well, if you had the pond level. Sounds familiar. I might be wrong. You're definitely racing some wacky and zany places. Right, now we've got the money, I'm going to go put some of those wheels on. We can just see what they're like. We'll do a race we've already done. There you go. Spiky wheels. Come here. Yeah. We'll do that combat race we just did. See how different it is with spiky wheels. Someone's asking if I've ever played Age of Empires. I played far too much Age of Empires. Ah, we got rocketed. Oh, ice cube. Enjoy. Come on, come here. I want to spike you. All right, you get rocketed. Ah, didn't need to break then. I could have just rammed into the side of him. That worked. Not so much on the driving front, but let him catch up because I want to. Dodges rockets apparently. Come here, come here. That's the one. You like those spikes, don't you? Seems it slows them down if you hit them. Oh, come on, how did none of you hit that acid? Yay, dropped a giant bomb and got someone. Got three hits on the acid bath. I think they're too far behind for the bombs to be any use now. Well, the tyres seem pretty effective, I'll give it that much. That was a comfortable victory. Right, let's have a quick look at what's capable of going on in multiplayer, if we can find any. Nope. So that's the only problem with this game. Currently, it doesn't look like it has a very active player base. Admittedly, it's, you know, the afternoon in the UK on a weekday, so it's not prime time. But something to be aware of. You may want to check how many people are actually playing the game before you go purchasing it if you are expecting to come across multiplayer. And that is where I'm going to wrap up Tabletop Racing World Tour. Hopefully, if you like the look of it, you'll enjoy playing it. It's £10.99 at the moment, I believe. I think there's an offer for if you buy a pack for you and your friends, you know, the four-pack style offers they sometimes do. If it's not your thing, at least now you know. So, for the guys watching back on YouTube later, thank you for watching and bye for now.